Hi, in this video, we're gonna finish up our game, so we'll add a shadow to the characters, then add another level, and then publish the game online so that anyone can play it. So let's open our project and get started. First of all, we're gonna fix up the player's mask a little, because right now if you go against a front wall, it looks like this, but realistically, it should look like this, so we're gonna work on that. For that, we are first of all gonna open the SPR player idle down sprite. We're gonna use this sprite as the mask for the player. So let's open the collision mask menu. And from here, I'm gonna set the mode to manual. After changing the mode, you're gonna be able to resize the mask yourself. So here, I'm gonna resize it so that the head part isn't included in the mask. Now the mask is ready, so the only thing we have to do is to use it. I'll open OBJ player. And here in the properties, you can change the mask sprite. I'll set it to the SPR player idle down sprite that we just edited. And now this sprite is gonna be used as the mask of this object, no matter which sprite you have assigned to it. So now if you run the game and you go against a front wall, it's gonna look correct. And this way you can change the mask of any sprite in your game and then use it for any object. Now we're gonna draw the shadow under the player and the enemies, and for this we already have a sprite, so now we need a function to draw the shadow. To hold the function, which needs to be global, I'll make a new script and I'll call this drawing, just so it can hold any drawing related functions. In the script, I'll make the function draw shadow. It'll have one argument, which will be the vertical offset of the shadow, and it will have a default value of 0. So what this means is that this argument is now optional. So you don't have to pass it when you call the function, but you can pass it if you want it to have a different value than its default value of 0. Now in the function, I'll use drawSpriteEXT to draw the shadow sprite. I'll draw it at the instances x and y position, and I'll add the offset to the y position. Then I'll use the default x and y scale, default rotation, default color, and then finally, I'll set the opacity to 0.4. Now you can use this function anywhere to draw the shadow. So I'll go into OBJ player, and here I'll add the draw event. In the draw event, I'll first of all call draw shadow with an offset of 1 pixel, because I've tested this already and I know that an offset of 1 pixel works for the player. And then of course you want the player to draw itself, so I'll call draw self. Now to do the same in the enemies, I'll go into OBJ enemy parent, and here too, I'll add the draw event. Here I'll call draw shadow without any arguments, so it'll use the default offset of 0, and then I'll draw the enemy itself with draw self. Now let's run the game, and I'm noticing that where the shadow should appear, it's a weird visual glitch. This can happen in GameMaker, and if you get a visual glitch like this, sometimes just clearing the cache fixes it. So I'm gonna click this button to clear the cache. Then I'll run the game again, and now it appears properly. The enemies also have their shadows, and I'm gonna leave it up to you to add shadows to the NPCs. Now let's go into room 1, and if you remember, for the collision tiles, we just used the one tile for making our level. But if you go into the tiles called layer and look at the tile set here, we actually have a bunch of sprites for the walls that we didn't use, and we just used that one tile. So I'm gonna fix it up now. First of all, I'm gonna update this bottom part, so I'm gonna use these tiles and just place them wherever it's appropriate. And then I'll update the top part. For this, I'm gonna double the tiles here so that it looks like this. And you can see that this looks much better. You can also do the same here in the bottom part. You can then also add the shadow tiles here, just underneath all the walls, and this will also make it look much better. And now I'm just gonna go through the whole level and just repeat this, and just make all the wall tiles look better. Just make sure you are in the tiles core layer, because that's where we have the collision tiles of the walls. And once you are done doing this across the whole level, you're gonna notice, especially if you compare it with how it was before, that it looks much better now, and the walls also stand out. Now we're gonna add a second level to the game, and for that of course we need a second room. We have room 1 here already, so I'm gonna right click on that, duplicate it, and name the new one room 2. If you click here, you can see the room order used in the game. So room 1 is first, it has the home icon. It means that this room will open first when you start your game. So let's double click on room 2 and open it. We need to clear it first. So let's go into the tiles back layer. I'm gonna use the select tool from here. I'll select everything in the room and then I'll press delete on the keyboard to delete everything. Then let's go into the tiles call layer. Then use the same tool and repeat that. So we delete everything in this layer. And then for the instances, let's go into the instances layer. I'll hold shift on the keyboard, then drag with my mouse to select all the instances apart from the player, and then I'll delete them. And now we can start designing our second level. So I'll go to the tiles back layer and design this. Then I'll go into tiles call and put down the walls. And then I'll go into the instances layer and add in the enemies and any NPCs that you want to add. Our second level is ready now, so all we have to do now is to find a way to switch from the first level into the second level. And we're gonna do that using an NPC. So you'll talk to that NPC at the end of your first level, and after that dialogue is over, you'll be transported to the second room. To set this up, let's first go into Object Dialog and open the create event. Here I'll make a variable called next room, and this will be false by default. So when this is true, what it means is that when the dialogue ends, we should switch over to the next room. To make that work, I'll go into the end step event, and let's go under the condition where we find that the array is over and then destroy the instance. In the same block, if next room is true, then we're gonna go to the next room. Now we need to set up a variable in the NPC so we can mark it as the final NPC of a level. For that, let's go into obj NPC parent. Let's go into the variables here and make a new variable called final NPC. I'll make this a Boolean type of variable so that it can be true or false, and I'll set it to be false by default. Now to make this work, let's go into the step event and let's go under the condition where the input key is pressed and the dialog is created. Here, if this is the final NPC, then we're gonna set the next room variable in the dialog instance, and we're gonna set it to true so that when the dialog is over, it goes over to the next room. Now, because we are about to add a new NPC, we need dialog for it. So let's go into the dialog script, and here I'm gonna make a new global array. I'll call this room 1 end because it's the end of room 1. I'll add the first message struct. This will be from cross. And then the message will say this. Then I'll add a comma and then duplicate this struct to make the second message. And this will say this. And now we can add this to an NPC. So let's go into room 1. And here I'm gonna place an NPC at the end of the level. I'll double click on it, open its variables, edit dialog, and set it to global.room1end. I'll also edit final NPC and set this to true, so that after you're done talking to this NPC, you go to the next room. So let's run our game and go to the end of the level. After you're done talking to this NPC, you're gonna go to the second room and your second level will start. Now finally, we're gonna upload our game to GX Games so that anyone can play it. First of all, we need to sign in. So go here, click on sign in and just make sure that your account is logged in. Once you are logged in, you'll see this message, so you're good to go. Before uploading, let's go into the game options from here and click on GX Games. Here, let's set a game name, then click on register, and then click apply. Now to upload, let's go here and make sure that the GX Games target is selected. Then let's click on the create executable button. And from here, select Upload as Game. Once it's done uploading, you're gonna see this. So click on Edit Game on Opera. And once it takes you to the website, you may have to sign in here as well. Once you have signed in, your game will show up here. You can click on it to open it. Let's go to the Publish menu. And from here, click on Copy Link. You can open this link in a new tab and play your game. And you can then share this same link with anyone and they'll be able to play your game as well. Now you can see that this is looking blurry, and for this there's a simple fix. Go back to the game options for GX Games, click on graphics, and disable the interpolate colors between pixels option, click on apply. Then you can just upload your game again and this issue will be fixed. Now this link is private, as in anyone can access it through the link, but people won't be able to find your game on GX.games itself. So to publish it publicly, there is a tutorial we have, so click on this. We also have this playlist that has tutorials for how to implement a main menu into your game, add sound effects and music, and also add gamepad support. And while this is the end of the planned RPG series, if there is one bonus episode that you could add to this, what would it be? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one.